The Financial Survival Network, helping you to survive and thrive in the new economy.
This is the Financial Survival Network.
Financial Survival Network is presented to you by Regal Assets. Buy and sell physical gold and silver through your existing retirement plan, 100% tax-free with Regal Assets. If you want to include physical gold or silver in your existing IRA or old 401k, request your free investment kit, which was recently featured in the Forbes and Smart Money Wall Street Journal magazines. Call toll-free 855-678-6620, 855-678-6620, or visit regalassets.com.
This year, it appears that corporate profits are going to be the worst since the depths of the crash in 2009, and Daryl Shoon has been studying this for a while. He's going to talk to us about it. Hey, Daryl, welcome to financialsurvivalnetwork.com.
Hi, Kerry. It's good to be back.
Always great to have you here. You know that. So I'm reading your blog, which is drshoon.com, and you have like no happy news on this blog. I mean, it must have been some kid's birthday who had a kid at who had a party at like Chuck E. Cheese or McDonald's or something good must have happened in the world. Am I crazy here?
Maybe I should put a birthday notice every day to offset it. You know, Kerry, the reason why my blog is so overwhelmingly negative, it's got one purpose, because there is good spots. But I basically do it to offset what the main media is trying to do. What the major media is trying to do, it's a con game to try and make people feel good about what is happening. And the truth is that con game is dangerous. It's highly dangerous. Their intent is to make American consumers or consumers everywhere feel confident to indebt themselves further so their money debt credit machine will continue because it is badly damaged. And they did this since the 1980s when they flooded the U.S. With consumer credit. Americans got credit cards, went on a spending binge that drove Asian supply markets, I mean, through the roof. Taiwan, next Japan, after Japan, it was South Korea, and then China, all right? And at the end of this, the American consumer was so heavily indebted. So what they did, they constructed another bubble in addition to this credit bubble, which affected the real estate market. So what happened is Americans then had felt so good that they went out and mortgaged the source of their greatest security, their home. All right. And people took, you know, those cruises to the Bahamas that they always wanted. They went up to Alaska, and some of them, if they didn't do that, you know, got a home improvement loan and put in that granite countertop. They put in the great room, and they, you know, made a fancy barbecue area back intending to flip their house and make even more money. Well, you had the collapse of this enormous credit bubble in 2008. It had been already on very, very shaky grounds before then. But in 2008, it really collapsed. And what they have been trying to do, I call these people the credit meisters. What the credit meisters have been trying to do, because consumer confidence is a component, because when people become cautious, when people become wary of their environment, they start pulling back. All right? Now, this is your core audience, Kerry. You are talking to people who have become somewhat leery of what's going on around them, despite what the positive news that the media is always trying. They're cheerleaders. All right?
Sure.
Now, my negativity, apparent negativity, is not to bum people out and to increase the amount of medication that Americans are taking, which is already an all-time high. My purpose is exactly what yours is, Kerry. I started this trying to warn people, most of whom didn't want to hear, that they were on thin ice and that the ice was getting warmer and warmer and warmer. And I, you know, if there's another way to tell these people that that is in fact a reality, than putting on the constant stream of news, which you find on my site.
The antidote to make believe that the government is pushing to keep
you spending.
They're
all trying to sell it to you. Because the truth of the matter is, Kerry, is that, and the truth is, neither you and I want the bottom to fall out.
Of course not.
Neither you nor I want this horrific event that is we're in front of to happen. But the difference is, you and I both know it is going to. All right? And yep. The only way you can mitigate it is not to close your eyes and deny that it's happening. The only way you can mitigate it is to protect your assets in such a way that you have some stability to get through what is coming, because I assure you, it is coming. And to know it, and then to otherwise just go about your daily life. You know, when I leave this house, I don't sit around and think, holy smokes, this place is going to go to toast. I better buy that toaster at Walmart right now at $12, my two-piece toaster, because
so you
in
could
three
go
years
fight.
It's going to be $4,600 with hyperinflation,
So you could fight on Black Friday. Maybe you should wait.
Yeah.
Because I think you'd enjoy that much more,
These are dicey times, Kerry. These mm-hmm. are dicey times. And all I'm trying to do is to warn people that it is far dicier than they even suspect. And that's it. That's why I write the things I do.
Yeah, well, I mean, I agree with you, because all they hear about, and it's fading, it's really fading now. I mean, how many people really believe that bogus jobs number that came out last Friday? It was pure fraudulence.
The disconnect between what we're told and what we know to be true is getting wider. It's a virtual chasm, all right? And I know that people hope that it is getting better, but I want to tell you, this is what my thing is. It will get better for you only if you do something about it while you still can. All right. Yeah. And if you don't open your eyes, that doesn't make what's going to happen go away. It only means it's going to get bigger when you do open your eyes. And, we are in one of the – we're in an extraordinary period of time. And I look at history. I'm sort of fascinated with the story of our of our path, all right? Mm-hmm. It's fascinating. We've never been here.
Yeah.
We've never been in a place where the whole planet is on what I call funny money, on fiat money. Never.
Mm-hmm.
Never.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't have noticed it the day before, nor the difference the day before, nor the day after. I think it was August 21st, 1971. The day before,
right.
August 20th, I mean, people got up, had their, coffee, read the newspaper, and went on their business. The next day, all money became fiat. When the United States cut the convertibility of the U.S. dollar to gold, and because all currencies under the Bretton Woods Agreement were based on the U.S. dollars being converted to gold, that meant every currency in the world, not just the American currency, was no longer convertible to gold.
Right.
Now, this was the first time in the history of the world that gold had been totally demonetized from money. Now, the history of the world, all right? And yet, on the day after that, people got up in the morning, drank their coffee, read the Sunday newspaper, may have read about what they had done. They may have read the media planted story of where the United States said, we've done this because, and it's going to be better. It's going to do this, do this, do this, do this, do this. And it's going to be better for what we've done. Other than that, no one noticed the difference. No one. But that didn't mean that event did not occur. That did not mean that event was not going to have severe consequences down the line. All right. That was 1971. This is 2012. This is 32 years later.
It's 42.
It's 42. It's like it's metastasized. All right. This event, it's like a cancer. It may have started out as a single cell. The next day it might have grown to two. The next day it may have grown to four. We are now in a monetary environment, 41 years later, that it is the predominant factor in the world global scene. And we're almost at the tipping point. We don't know where it is. That's the one thing when you're in this. Once you look at it, you realize you don't know the timing. All right? Because the more you know it's going to happen, the more you think, oh, it's going to happen any day. But it happens. It's going to happen when it happens. And we don't know how much time there is left before it happens. I want to assure people, the world's, it's not going to be like the people thought in the world in 2000, when 2000 hit, the world was going to disappear and, you know, whatever they thought. And it's not going to be like in 2012, when another group of people think it is going to be, it's going to end. In both instances, and in our instance, it's not going to end. But it is going to be significantly different. Yeah, when this event happens, it's going to be significantly different the day after than the day before. That is what is true.
Yeah, that's for sure. Because we're going to be looking for most people at substantially decreased standards of living. We've had that already. I mean, let's face it, since 1971, the average American worker, his standard living
salary going. Keep telling you this is all right, but we know already that in the era I grew up in, Kerry, both my parents worked, but even in that era, generally you had a single family wage earner, and he had enough to provide for the family. All right, didn't matter what kind of job he had.
Sure,
he could provide for his family. He could have been a plumber. He could have been a carpenter. He could have been a bond trader. All right. Now, the difference between those days and these days is that the difference between the income of the carpenter and the bond trader is grown exponentially. It's grown exponentially. Yeah. But for the most of Americans, they've seen an erosion in the quality of life, in their income, and their ability to provide for their family that's only been offset by their ability to borrow. That's how Americans have made up for the difference in their loss of real wages, in inflationary costs that have been subsumed by the data boys who make up these figures to make us believe that there is no inflation. Mm-hmm. We have made up the difference. I mean, first, by women having to go to work, all right? And for some, it was an opportunity to be able to do things they hadn't done before. But the truth of the matter is, most people would not work if they didn't have to. And that includes the fathers, all right?
And it was awful for the kids, too, growing up without the mother.
So, but this is just what happened. And then that didn't work. That didn't fill the plug, all right? It went back to credit. Now, that people don't understand the relationship between the two. It was the growth of credit, Kerry, that made everything more expensive.
Oh, yeah, like college, medical, everything.
Yeah. If we didn't have credit, it would not cost as much to buy whatever we buy. But the fact that you have a credit card, the fact that if I have a credit card, and we're going to look at the same toaster at Walmart, or if you have an unlimited line of credit, and so do I, and we're looking at the same house in Westchester, you know?
Yeah,
it's going to go up. Or if we're going to the same doctor, or we want to go to we want to send our kids to the same school, it's going to go up. Yeah. This is what we're in. We've never been here before.
Yeah, I always say to people, how expensive do you think a car would be if there was no financing, cut rate financing available for it? How expensive would your college education be if there were no student loans? And how expensive would medical care be if there was no Medicare and Medicaid and any government involvement in these marketplaces?
Now, the truth of the matter is, Kerry, the government came in only later. The government, you can't blame this on the government. You can blame them for riding the horse off the cliff because they've done it. But it was the bankers that did it.
Oh, yeah.
It was the bankers, and they know us. What is the most important things to us, Kerry? It's our health
and our family,
our better tomorrow. These two things have shown an exponential growth in cost over every other area. Why? Because you and I can do without buying that set of golf clubs that we've been looking at. All right? You and I can do without, you know, going to Paris this Christmas, you know, that we've been thinking of. But neither you and I are really willing to sacrifice our health or the future well-being of our children if education is a critical component. So on the list of needs, you have that lock of cost. It's an escalator. But at the top of the escalator is a cliff of financial perdition.
So the cure is to grow wings so you can fly off that cliff, to grow golden and silver wings. So you just flap your wings and you land smoothly and softly on the ground while everyone else around you is going head first, doing head plants into the dirt.
Yeah, it's as simple as that. And for those who don't have it, faith. I mean, you really got to hold your mind in this time. My deal, I've always said, Gary, buy gold, buy silver, have faith. Those three. And then when you do that, then you could look at what you want to do after you've had your latte this morning and read the newspaper and maybe my bad news on my blog.
Oh, man, I feel like you're talking to me when you're making fun of people having lattes. But, you know, the fact is, how much is that Starbucks latte going to be when it all hits the fan? You know, if they get half a buck for it, then, because I believe we're going to have this monetary revaluation, everything, global reset, all debts are going to have to be forgiven because they can't be paid. If you can't pay, what do you do?
You know, Kerry, in the old, what we call the old days and not our old days, in the biblical days, they had something called the Jubilee.
I'm very familiar with it.
All right. Why?
Yeah.
Because they had to. If they didn't have the Jubilee, they would have driven everybody into the ground. Yep. They had to have a debt forgiveness.
Yeah, but back then, you know, your debt wasn't necessarily somebody else's asset. Now you're going to have an asset jubilee, which means wholesale liquidation of the financial sector, because they're counting on you to pay your debt, you meaning whether it's the federal government or your student loan or your auto loan or your mortgage, and the money ain't going to exist. So therefore, the debt isn't going to exist, because a debt that can't be paid is no debt at all.
Right? Kerry, you should go and take people in to argue on their debt forgiveness. They should take you in to see their mortgage, to see their banker at J.P. Morgan with their $250,000 mortgage. They're underwater, $100,000. And you can sit down and by using your reasoning, you could say that this apparent debt that my clients have is really no debt at all, Mr. Banker.
and go spend 3 years foreclosing on that house. And in the meantime, my client, Mr. Banker, is going to strip the paint off the walls and resell the paint. So if you want to have an empty shell with no windows and no appliances, no water heater, no heat, no hot water, we'll pull out all the copper, have at it, because that's what you're going to wind up with. And that's what's been going on in Vegas, which is why if you are behind on your mortgage in many places and they know that foreclosure is inevitable, they're paying you in some places, Daryl, I've heard this and I believe it to be true, anywhere from $15,000 to $25,000 just to leave without a fight and don't bust the place up.
Yeah, because don't mess it up before you leave.
Because it'll cost them way more than that to ever make it marketable, and the odds are they won't be able to, and they'll just knock it down like Detroit.
Yeah. You know?
So, the forgiveness is really the only way. There's nothing else that can be done.
You're right.
Yeah.
Hey, Kerry, didn't Jesus come and say forgiveness was the key?
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Maybe it's coming
through. Yeah. You're so funny.
People have always said the Bible was, you know, the New Testament was really impractical, that you couldn't do it. Maybe it's the last chance option. It's the only thing we're going to be able to do in every sense of the word.
Yeah, that's it. that's it. But at least we're all pretty much in the same boat, you know?
Yeah.
So, so at least, you know, misery enjoys company. We'll all go down together, most of us. But if you have some gold, it will definitely, and some silver, it'll definitely be a lot easier.
A lot easier.
Yeah.
A lot easier. So, that's absolutely true, Gary.
Yeah. Well, we're going to have to see what happens, Daryl. But on that note, yeah. So your blog, drshoon, S-C-H-O-O-N.com, highly recommend it. But make sure you have your coffee and your latte first before
and
you sit down.
Maybe your medication.
Yeah. And if you're on antidepressants, highly recommend some Zoloft before you get into the meat of it. But no, honestly, the reason why it's really a good thing and you shouldn't be upset and you shouldn't be depressed by any of this is that if you are prepared, you will get through it fine. There will be hardships for everyone.
Everybody.
But you'll have a fighting shot.
Yep. Very good, Kerry.
All right, Daryl. Hey, always a pleasure. We will talk to you soon.
Pleasure on this site, too.
All right. You be well.
You too. Thanks.